What is up, guys? Tyler here with the Kingdoms Trading Card Game, and in today's video, I'm going to be finally giving you that deck profile video of the Esther Tower spammy deck. So let's go ahead and jump into the video.
So what are you running in this deck?
Wait, no.
Four. Got three Mountain Yetis in here.
Okay.
These bad boys do their job.
Yep.
Then we got three Tulsa Guardmen. Okay. So along with three Esther Towers.
Yep.
Along with two Esther Soldiers, along with two Pack of Wolves. Then we have one Commander Tulsa. Then we have one Lord Estercross. Then we have one Frontline Warrior. We have Outpost Tower.
And Neutrals.
Yes, sir. Then we have Executor. It's a great for Phase 3. Then we have Silversmith. Run two of those. We have a Disciplined Soldier.
Okay.
Run two of those. Temple Teacher, great, just to need an extra card, along with Watchmaker. Then we have Stone Thrower, just run one of those, along with Time Scribe. Bison Herd. New to the deck is Ula.
Good old Ula.
Skilled Worker.
Yep.
And Power, this is a great card.
Not the spells. Okay.
And then we have three Earthquakes.
Yep.
Along with Block.
Yep.
Along with Wishing Well. Cancel Spell. Divine Wisdom, I'm sorry. Then we have Restore.
Okay.
Haven't really had a chance to use it. That's a great
card. For Legends.
Yeah, Threatening Warrior. Second Hand Chance. Summoner's Call. Utility Boy, this is a great card.
Yeah.
Firestorm, really haven't had a chance to use that one. Then we have 3-4 tokens. Then we have that one.
Sorry, Circle.
Then we have Fabric of, I cannot pronounce that.
Okay.
Pure Water.
Yep.
Big boy Mr. Esterbrook himself.
Alright. Yeah,
then we are moving on to the spirits. I run two Charlottes because these things are OP.
Mm-hmm.
I run one Biotin for Forceful
Sumerian.
Sumerian. Oh, both in the Forceful Advice.
Yeah.
Yep.
Then Sumerian.
Okay, so that's what you got. And then what order do you run your sacreds in?
Where are my sacreds?
We'll move these back so that way we can.
I always have my first spot. The first spot is always picked by opponent.
Okay.
I run library and then I run fortress. Library is great because second hand gives me the power to attack in third phase. And then I have this fortress just to help me get through all the way. Or Skylight Fountain, I'm sorry.
Gotcha. Now what's your main strategy with this deck? Like, what cards are you trying to use or get to?
Charlotte. Always trying to get to her. Always trying to get to Charlotte. Because once I get to Charlotte, if you look at her Impact 11,
mm-hmm.
it states, if two of the same defensive cards are in the pile and they are bleed, you can pull them out. Well, lucky for me, if we have find them here.
Those towers.
Yes, sir. Pull these towers out.
Yep.
Get those in there as fast as I can. I want at least one and phase one discard into the pile. So that way, I'll keep pulling them out in an endless loop. Make sure I get my tokens. I need those tokens.
Yeah.
Just to get through that Impact 11.
Right.
When worst comes to worst, I always like to pull out a great combination here, if I can find them again. Is, let's see if I can find
it. What card are you looking for?
I'm looking for Mr. Esterbrook. This card runs great with him.
Very expensive. Mm.
Yeah. But still, if you can pull it off, it's pretty good.
And I've pulled it off a few times. It's been very, very productive.
Well, awesome, guys. Well, if you got any thoughts or modifications to that, post in the comments below. Thank you, Zach.
Thank you guys so much for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you have any ideas or modifications that you think would be of value to that deck, put it in the comments below. I do want to end this video with a Bible talk, as I like to do in every single video, and I want to encourage you in this one to make sure you are spending time with God. I know the last 3 days, at the moment of me recording this video, sorry, my phone is going off. I know in the last 3 days, for me personally, at the recording of this video, I have not done so great with my devotions, spending time with God on a daily basis. It's something I highly encourage and actually kind of make a mandatory thing to do for our student leaders and our youth group, and it's because it is so important that we spend time with God. And we need to find the right time to do that in the morning, in the evening, in the afternoon. And so I want to encourage you, if you are watching this video, the moment you are done watching, and maybe it's something that I will do myself the moment I am done recording this video, make sure you go spend some time with God, spend some time in scripture, and spend some time in prayer, because He desires to have a relationship with you. Please like this video, put a comment below, let me know what you thought. Also, check out the Facebook and Instagram, and also the Discord server and the website. There's a lot of stuff coming at you guys, trying to give you a lot of different ways to connect, get more familiar with the game, and connect with the Kingdom's community. Thank you guys so much for watching this video.